prophecy seems to be belonging to a comparatively remote future. But what you can visualize from this would be much less than what would happen actually. Because the Christians of that time could not visualize what sort of mastery was in store for them in the future relative to that time. And they couldn't imagine what great naval powers would emerge even from a small island like the British island. You know, they conquered the whole world through their supremacy in navy. And still, despite the age of Star Wars and everything, the importance of naval warfare in as decisive factor in the future world war is not ignored by the great world powers. In fact, recently I read an article in a technical authentic magazine from America, which disclosed that while we have been concentrating on Star Wars and rockets and things, constantly, without let or hindrance, the Russians have been improving their naval power, with the result that now they have got the edge over us. Just the Russians alone have got greater naval power now than the entire naval powers combined of European powers and America and so on. Why? Because Russia realizes that the future world war may be fought in the heaven and in stars, etc. But the decision will be taken here on earth. And in that decision, Navy is still going to play the most important role. So whatever is left of the world after this great world war, which is pending and imminent, we don't know what may happen, but in the era afterwards, as predicted by the Holy Quran, inshallah, Islam, as presented by Ahmadiyyat, would rapidly spread. And a new phase would emerge in which a new type of mastery over airs would be given to the followers of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. Is this a common cap for everybody to use? Moreover, when you want to borrow somebody's cap, don't directly pick it from them. It is supposed to be a sign of insult. Huh? Please ask somebody to hand you over the... Okay. Was it yours he had taken?
No, it's not mine.
The way you did it, I thought it was yours. Yes, please.
My name is Khalid Purvez and I'm from Los Angeles, California.
Dr. Khalid Purvez.
Yes, it is.
Yes? What about that lawsuit against you?
Against me?
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
that you're neglecting some operation or something and...
I didn't
see. Has it been resolved?
That has not been resolved.
Has it been resolved?
Not yet.
Not yet?
Yet. Oh.
But of course you are insured, I hope.
I am,
so why are you so much worried? I mean, it is the insurance company you should be worried.
If you
quite. So what's your question now?
Deadly disease going on in all over the world, especially USA, also called AIDS, acquired immune deficiency disease. Every day we hear on the TV in USA that from the East, especially the East, they come and they talk, not the medical doctor, the medical doctor said to the surgeon, that this is only because people are having non-biblical practices. That's why this disease has come from the God of people. And when somebody gets this disease, he is dead. After now,
you're talking about AIDS?
AIDS.
Yes, yes.
Nobody survived at this time. So how far do you think that the female is going to be? Do we have to do that kind of thing?
Well, I don't know about the non-biblical, but I know about the non-Quranic practices, which are naturally punished by Allah, generation after generation. And this is one of those. You know, when you become promiscuous in your sexual relationship to a point where there is no limit left, then what punishment awaits you in the future or in your family relationships, that is a different thing altogether. There is also a material punishment which is attached to this crime to occur as a natural phenomenon, as a natural consequence. And this we have been seeing in the past in the form of venereal diseases which are progressive. If a venereal disease appears, it seems to be a great source of misery for the mankind, and ultimately mankind is able to overpower it. Another appears which is as defiant as the previous one, or even more. Then when you think that you have ultimately done away with it, then a third one appears, even more horrible in some aspects. You know, at one time, gonorrhea seemed to be a most terrible disease, and much more than that, syphilis was considered to be the last word in the punishment in this regard. Later on, when the scientific progress is advanced in these regions, syphilis was more easily controlled through the use of penicillin than gonorrhea. Although gonorrhea played at that time less havoc with human beings than syphilis did, but syphilis was brought under control more easily than gonorrhea, and it continued. But later on, recent efforts, also brought gonorrhea under control, but from it emerged a different type of disease related to this, which is called herpes. I don't know the second part of it, it's not zoster, but herpes, which is related to venereal diseases. Herpes?
Simplex.
And genital?
Both
are called. Herpes genitalis?
Herpes simplex type 1, herpes genitalis.
Quite. They're two different types?
Two.
Right. So these two herpes have replaced this punishment. And as far as my studies have revealed, they have not been able to find any remedy for herpes which could be considered as permanent cure. It comes and goes and comes and goes and never leaves you. And it's so painful and so torturous that sometimes it makes the person a total nervous wreck. And how they could tackle with it, they still did not know. While they were yet searching for an effective remedy against this type of herpes, there comes the AIDS. And this aid has sunken deeper into life forces. The fact is that the aid virus is very similar to parts of our defensive systems. And it sort of, you know, acquires a disguise and sinks into the defensive system cells. Either T cells or B cells, I don't remember, T cells. And it defies all efforts of the defense system because it sits right in the middle, in the heart of the defensive system itself. And so far they have not been able to find an effective remedy for this. So what I mean to say is that the more promiscuous the society becomes, the more defiant it becomes. Nature, under Allah's command, is inventing new ways of punishment to the society. This is for those who do not believe in God. If you do not believe in God and you are left unpunished, then disbelief in God would spread even more rapidly. You have no checks, no automatic brakes applied to the tendency to go mad after pursuit of pleasure and so on. So these are definitely